Esports hot topics, hot tweets, and the spiciest memes. I'm Marissa Roberto.
You are indeed, and I am Brody Moore, and this is how the show is gonna work. We're gonna present all the goodies we've gathered, in which we will discuss and most likely argue. But luckily for all of us, there is a mute button here to be used once, where we can shut the other person up.
Oh, how delightful it shall be. Listen, shout out to chat. We like it when you call us out when we're wrong and praise us when we're spitting the truth. So let's get to it, shall we? Our top story today is about none other than the perpetually burning drama that is associated with Denial Esports. Esports player advocate Sir Scoots is openly pressuring MLG and PUBG Corp to remove Denial Esports from both the Call of Duty World League and PUBG Esports. He has long sided with Denial's players, who allege that the team has repeatedly failed to pay them. Sir Scoots wants both organizers to not only remove Denial from their respective leagues, but to give the slots to the players and allow them to find new teams. Brody.
Hi.
What is the right call in this situation? Because you got to think about business, but you also got to think about players. So what's the right call?
Okay, well, first I'm going to shout. I may disagree with Sir Scoots. I love you, Sir Scoots.
Really?
And maybe he has more information, so that's a disclaimer at the beginning. Maybe he knows more.
He definitely does, because he's much smarter than you.
So it's hard to go against him, but without the information I would have,
yes.
I would just say, how can you pressure Denial? Because we don't know the information, you know? Sure, they've come to fire a few times, but we mentioned it before, that could just be players knowing that that could work and trying to get away with stuff. Maybe there aren't actually problems. Maybe they don't know how to read contracts. And we all know that pro players don't know how to read contracts. Mm-hmm. So it could be a misunderstanding that the players think they're entitled to more than they actually have, and Denial isn't in the wrong. But of course, people are going to believe the players because they're the players, right?
Okay.
So it's really hard to make a decision here without the actual facts out there.
Okay, the
but
facts,
I don't know.
The overarching fact remains here that players have been and will continue to be taken advantage of in this world because there's no real union in mm-hmm. place. And that's what Sir Scoots has been trying to do for a long time.
Yeah.
And he's actually been pretty successful with it up to this point. He just has always been an advocate for gamers, and that's why I love and appreciate him. He's been in the scene for a long time, and before any of us even breathed the word esport, he was in it and he was there for the players mm-hmm. 100. So of course he's going to be advocating for these players here who have been left high and dry. They've been left with nothing. And sure, we don't know what was in their contracts. No, not at all. But these leagues always side with the orgs because the orgs are the business. And unfortunately, the players just fall by the wayside.
So I'm 100 on getting behind players having, you know, like a union to get together, to work together and not get taken advantage of.
For sure.
I do also think, though, that orgs are being taken advantage of too. Where's their money? Like they have a lot of investment, but what's the ROI on this, right? Mm. Not all the orgs are making money
Return
back right
on
now.
Investment.
Yeah, so they need to also understand that the orgs are business and need to make money too.
For sure.
So
they do. They need
there
to be
are two
getting
sides to this.
Yes, they need to be getting mm-hmm. people investing in them. They need to be getting, pulling in more money from mm-hmm. outsiders, from sponsors, absolutely. And stuff like this, all the stuff coming out is for sure tainted this org completely. Unless they're getting investors from the outside world of esports, they don't know anything about this, and they don't know that Denial's been tainted in some way. Oh, we're running out of time.
Yeah, we are over time.
You should have muted me.
I should have, but I want to use it later probably. So PUBG and PUBG Mobile have long struggled with hackers, but in the case of the latter, reports of hacking have been on the rise. Mm. The developers have been listening to the complaints and have announced that players found cheating will receive a 10-year ban. Some players are concerned that the ban will affect them because the notice says that anyone using unauthorized third-party apps will be banned, and many of them use apps to change the graphical settings. Mm. I have opinions, but I'll let you go first since
Thank
I got
you.
To read the news piece here. Is this the right way to get rid of hackers?
A 10-year ban? Yo, that is the lifespan of an esports player. That is the lifespan of somebody even playing this game. They're gonna they'll fall off of the game completely and not even play it. I feel like that ban is actually just hurting this game if they want these players to continue playing, right? So, I mean, that's my perspective on it. It seems very harsh, especially if some players are saying, listen, they just use this for, you know, graphical changes and it's not actually changing anything in-game.
Mm-hmm.
But if they're using apps or they're using different things that the developer didn't make themselves, then they have every right to tell them, hey, you can't play our game.
The whole thing comes down to is innocent people are gonna get hurt here.
Mm.
You're gonna have innocent players. I use like Reshade and stuff when I'm playing PUBG because it changes just the, I can change the gamma settings, I can change the contrast, all that stuff.
Okay, but see, like that, would that not assist you in game to make you, could you not see people a little better or your opponents a little bit better?
For my eyes, but everyone's reshade settings are different. Also, everyone has access to these tools, right?
Yeah, but not every, like, for someone like me who just plays games for what they are, I never change anything. I even, like, some of these mods that you show me, I'm like, how the F are people doing this? I have no clue. Like, it's beyond my comprehension at all. So,
yeah,
for me to jump into a pub and play against someone like you, I feel like then you have an upper hand.
But you're not gonna beat me without reshade either.
That is a fair point, but the fact that you have another leg up on someone that wouldn't know how to do that, that's not fair.
I don't know. It's the same thing as like playing a video game. Like, you know, any video game I play, I turn the graphic settings to low immediately, right? So some players jumping into it might not know they can even have those options,
exactly.
But they're there by the developers. So it's really no different than that. It's just easier on my eyes. It's like a colorblind mode, right? It's just easier for some people's eyes or to see things, right? So no, innocent people are gonna get hurt here, and the hackers are just gonna make new accounts and hack again. Like, you're literally not gonna stop anything.
Once hack again. Listen, we gotta move on. Super Mario Maker 2 will feature online multiplayer. That seems like great news, but it comes with a big caveat. You can't play with friends online, only with strangers. Nintendo said that this was done because playing with friends would compromise the global leaderboards. But even if you play cooperatively, which has no leaderboards, you can't play with your friends. Brody, I'm assuming you do not agree with Nintendo's decision here or their reasoning, but do you think they maybe have a point?
No! Nintendo, forever and ever into the history of ever, has no friggin' idea how to do online. Jesus, Nintendo. You'd think now that you're starting to charge people to play online that you would start doing it right. It's been the worst experience using any kind of Nintendo system online. The only reason that I ever have any Nintendo system is to play single player games. I will never play online and I will never pay for their service because they have no gosh dang idea on what they're doing.
Oof.
It's awful. Why? Like, even as you mentioned, even if your leaderboard thing is an issue,
yeah,
then let people just play in like an unranked thing.
Yeah.
That's a thing. Video games have unranked and non-leaderboard game modes. Why not do that?
I don't know. I don't know. Maybe they think that people are inherently evil, and if they team up with other people, that'll make them even more evil.
The issue is if you baby people too much, you make an inferior service. You're already making people pay. That is the paywall to children. Children can't play online on that service without getting their parents to pay for it or sneaking their parents' credit card, right? But like, that is your barrier now. You've already created a safe place by making that barrier. A parent can say, I don't want my kid playing online, because that could be a dangerous place for them, right? Now, it's free to do whatever. Who cares? Like, stop trying to baby the people that are paying for your service.
Maybe
really.
Nintendo doesn't want to make people feel bad for having no friends.
Well, I have no friends and I still get around it. I want to
play
online.
Oh my God, you said it.
Well, I knew you were gonna get to it at some point.
No, it is a little infuriating though with this whole Nintendo thing, because even I have run into this problem just trying to play. I love playing Mario Kart. I love playing Mario Kart and just going online and playing, but I have to like phone a friend and let them know that we're gonna jump into this, try to jump into the same time.
And then you gotta find their friend code, which is 4,000 digits long.
Yeah, the friend code thing,
trash,
the friend code thing.
It's so bad, it's just a not fun experience overall.
No, really. It's just unfortunate. I wish that this would change, but I feel like Nintendo has always had their mode of operation and they haven't really ever listened to outsiders. They've only done their own thing, and they're a very successful company and will continue to be successful, so they don't care about you.
That's true. On the same track, though, the Pokemon Company just announced Pokemon Sleep, a mobile game where you sleep to train your Pokemon. That's not a joke at all. It's meant to be like Pokemon Go, only instead of walking, it will monitor your sleep data. You can even use a device called the Pokemon Go Plus to track it again. Is it a plus? Just one
plus.
Again, I have to emphasize that this is 100% not a joke, by the way, because I'm having a hard time believing in myself here. It sort of makes sense, but like, it's like it came out of nowhere. I woke up this morning and someone mentioned home and sleep, and I'm like, are these real?
Yeah.
Is this real life?
I don't understand this at all. How are you playing a game? Then?
So
are they gamifying sleep?
The way I understand it is, so I actually have an alarm clock that I use that you can set your phone on your bed and it uses an accelerometer, and the Go Plus ball or whatever it is has an accelerometer in it, and it tracks your sleep, so it knows when you're in REM and light sleep and all that, and it can actually change your alarm. What?
I'm sorry, both Tyler and our director Blaine is in my ear right now. They're like, he does not have an alarm clock for Colin BS.
Oh my God! I always. Even This is bullcrap. Can I mute everyone?
Oh my god. Okay, I'm sorry. Continue, Brody son.
So, what it does is, I don't use that app. I just said I have it. But it tracks your sleep, and it allows you to see if you're getting better sleeps or not. So that's what this could be used for. So maybe it'll say, okay, the longer you sleep, the more you're training your Pokemon. So it encourages you to get more sleep and have better sleeping habits.
So maybe this is a positive thing.
That's what I'm saying. This actually could be a good idea. And what it does is it further invests you into the Pokemon world, which is kind of cool. It's, you know, a lot of video games and a lot of experiences are just, you play the game, once you leave the screen, you're back in the real world. Yeah. Whereas this, it's almost like they're, when I was a kid, I used to run around the forest with my friend, pretending we're seeing Pokemon, and we're catching them, right? Like, it was so sick to do. So this could, my one and only, but this could be like that. This could be just bringing the Pokemon world into the real world even more so. Everything you do, actually IRL, can be Pokemonized.
Yeah, it's just crazy how like you had that friend and you pretended you were catching Pokemon, but now Nintendo won't let you play with that friend online.
Yeah, right? The irony of it all.
IRL. Okay, listen, we gotta move on. It's time to check in with streamers in Clip It. Our first clip comes from Pokemon, who received a donation asking her out on a date.
All these losers hitting on you and dono messages must get old after a while, huh? You should tell me all about it over dinner sometime. I can pick you up in my 1998 Toyota Tercel.
Why not all three?
And take you somewhere nice. Don't worry, I'll let you pay.
I would can I just look up 1998 Toyota images? Do you want me to refund the $5? Because honestly, it looks like you could use it more than I can.
Yo, that was savage.
Oh my god, I love Pokey
but
so
she
much.
Didn't say no.
Okay, don't be one of those internet bros. Ooh, she didn't say no.
I'm not an internet bro. She didn't say no.
Okay, yeah. Well, why would she's not gonna say yes either? Yo, guys,
you're also missing my joke here.
No, I'm not, Brody.
It's comedy.
Is it?
I'm a comedian. I make jokes. No, but I try. Certainly do. All right, move on. Our next clip comes from Joey Chaotic. I'm sorry. Who caught a perv in the act?
I totally just caught you taking a photo of their butt, sir. Dude, he just took a photo of. Picture with them? I can take you. No? I can ask them if they want a picture with you.
That's kind of. That's not cool.
You know what? Like, this is an actual issue that happens at cons of the freaking time.
Like, he brings up a good point. Go ask them if you want a photo with them. It's not that difficult.
Yeah, but I don't think she was there in cosplay. She was just wearing a skirt. This is an actual problem for women everywhere who wear skirts, BT dubs. I have to be extra careful when I go up the stairs because a perv is like lingering below just waiting for an upskirt shot. You know how disgusting you are, honestly? First of all, you can find this stuff online. Just Google it. Do not disturb these women. They're out there living their lives. They can wear whatever the F they want, and you should not be taking a photo of them unless you ask politely.
If you want an upskirt, ask them.
Not an
upskirt! That's what I'm getting out of this.
Oh my god!
Oh, I misread. My bad.
Ugh, pervs. It truly is the best time of day where we scroll the Twitters to bring you all the things the pros bless us with on their timeline. We love it when they subtweet the trolls, because let's face it, they're idiots and need to be reminded of that fact.
True.
So he says, sometimes I read hateful comments and just have to laugh. Bullies out there calling me a lesbian, something I'm not, but fully support and approve of. Or mom, something I aspire to be and look up to. Nerd, basically an honorary title in my world, so sick burns, LOL. Yeah, bullies behind the anonymity.
You got it.
Yeah, like they're just cowards, really. That's all it is.
Yeah.
It's just bullies behind a wall of like you're not even showing your face or your actual name. Like you're just a coward straight up. I guess bullies are cowards in general, but
yeah, I hate that. You gotta get more creative. You gotta get more creative with your insults, really. I mean, so many people want to play it online. Like the stupidest insults. They just say a name or something they think is insulting, which to me would not be insulting.
Yeah.
And I'm like, come on, I love trash talk. be creative. Like, come up with something.
Oh, no, 100. You have to be creative with that. Even if I'm at a baseball game or whatever it is and there are hecklers, I love hecklers. Hecklers are amazing, but they have to be creative and they have to be clever. And that's how you get people involved in the game. That's how you get people laughing. That's the same thing, too. It's like, I'm sure you had an awesome trip for Zoe and it was creative and it wasn't, like, insulting to her gender, for one thing, what she wears. I mean, that's one thing. Just be creative and be kind. Like, just if you think about how you would want to be chirped, right? It's always do unto others as you would have them do unto you.
How would I like to be insulted? Yeah. All right, our next thought helps to heal the guilt that Marissa feels when leaving an event and not remembering anything or anyone because she's old and isn't taking her ginkgo. Cherise says, just one thing, guys. Stop being mad or giving attitude to pro players or FTC personalities for not remembering your name. These people play, that's 47,383,738 persons a week. It's hard to keep up. Be polite and understanding. Real talk, though, you know, chirps aside on you is that, like, it's
tough.
Real. I
so
warn
tough.
People. Before going to an event, I warn people, hey, I'd love to meet you. Absolutely love to meet you. But please do not be offended if you come up to me, say your gamer tag, and I take a second to realize who you are.
Yeah.
Because hearing the names that I see in chat or online is way different, right?
Yeah,
like visually seeing your name and then hearing your voice.
Yeah.
And even if I've heard your voice sounds different through your crappy headset mic, than it does in real life. So
no, that's real.
We apologize, but you can't get mad at people to meet a lot of people.
I honestly just leave events feeling like an absolute idiot. I hate when people come to me and like, hi, how are you? And they like actually are talking to me like we've spoken before and I can't lock in the name. Like it'll drive me absolutely bananas. Then you stop, you're not even listening to them anymore because you're just trying to rack your brain for the name and you can't. You just hope that somebody else comes by so they can like shake their hand and they can introduce themselves to that person. You can catch the name. Oh my God, it is a scene out there, man.
For real.
All right, I gotta move.
Okay.
Our last profound thought comes from League of Legends pro Hanser, who has a very important question that needs answering. He tweets, this guy walks up to your girl and slaps her ass. What do you do? Froggen answers, I find a new girl. Okay, obviously he's joking because he doesn't have a girl.
Yeah, well, so he needs to find a new girl anyways.
That was my insult because he insulted and then I had to get him back.
Clever.
Yeah.
I'm lost. I have nothing clever. So let's just move on, okay? It's time for some crowd control. This is where we showcase some of the great gaming stuff the community is making and some maybe not so great stuff too. The first post reminds us who we have all that we have all been betrayed before or maybe have betrayed someone else. When your friend says they're going to bed, but you see them in the next match. It's almost like a surprise Pikachu. You ever had that?
That's so true.
Oh no, you don't play online.
No, that's real though.
Yo.
But that's anything, even if you're like tweeting and somebody's like, hey, I'm hitting the hay.
Real talk?
Okay. Real
talk you have to do though, because I've done that where like I just don't want to play with someone anymore. So like I'll wait till I know that they've queued for the next match and then I'll queue.
Rude. I feel like Zurich definitely does that to us all the time. Astronaut.
Yo, Zurich,
He does that to us all the time.
Bro.
He says he's going to be online and then he like mysteriously is not online and then he waits for somebody else to get online and then he jumps into his
Zurich
own match.
Straight up. I messaged him one time in Overwatch and I said, yo, you want to play? Literally 2 seconds later, he logs off the game. Literally 2 seconds later.
No, because he puts Steam on invisible. Like he's still there, but he makes himself invisible.
He's avoiding us. We're calling you out, buddy.
Zurich! All right.
Play games with us!
We've all seen FIFA Ragdoll breakdowns before, but we can't help but laugh every time a new one comes up.
All right, so you already know in FIFA, someone's tripping over someone.
Oh, hey. Hey now, you come here often? You're the guy just in the suit casually minding his own business?
Just completely off kilter, missing my target.
Brody, that's disturbing. I don't ever want to visualize that. Thank you.
Yeah, those are fun. Anyways, our last post reminds us, despite the peaceful music in Minecraft, the game can still throw you for one loop after another. Yeah, right. That's one of the chances another creeper was just waiting. Like, they planned that. They were scheming for days, you know?
The two of them? Like, one
creepers,
comes from the top? Yeah.
Yo, he's like, I got top, you got bottom. We're gonna mess this guy up. We'll get the sand glitch. He's going to fall right through. And he's going to think he's okay. Then all of a sudden, you're going to go.
Yeah. See, this is why I can't play Minecraft.
Why?
Because of them.
Well, you wouldn't even have had a cool train like that. You would have.
I know, it's true.
You wouldn't have gotten that far.
I told you I didn't get that far. It was a creeper that came after me. It all of a sudden became nighttime.
We need to play some Minecraft together.
I know, but then I just boxed myself in. I didn't even have a torch yet. I literally had nothing.
You're just in the darkness in a one-by-one box.
Exactly, hiding, waiting to hear the sound, the hissing sound go away, and it didn't. And I'm like, you know what?
Marissa's life, ladies and gentlemen.
That's all too real. Listen, that's it for Unmuted Today. Remember, you can hit us up on all our socials. Just say hi or send us stuff to react to. Someone type an exclamation mark, right? Socials right now in chat.